home of the Rockets in wonderful Houston, Texas. The excitement of the NBA is on the way. Chris Webber is joining us at the broadcast table alongside Greg Anthony and David Aldridge on the sideline. This is Kevin Harlan. A look at Charlotte. It's an opportunity for them to play in a heated matchup like this to play your best basketball. These are the games, guys, that show how well you match up against the other great teams in the league.
This is a team with high expectations, and they don't end with the regular season.
They sure don't. They entered the season with very high hopes and haven't let any distractions get in the way of them.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Well, of course it did. The D was nowhere to be found, and because of that, he easily sprinted it down the court and got an easy bucket.
And it's Capella missing. Here's Kidd Gilchrist. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the foul against Houston. And Chris, at the midway point of the season, are teams worried about peaking too early? Is that a real concern for teams?
Yeah, you know what? I've never understood the phrase peaking too early. I never understood what that meant. You know, you're supposed to try to win every game you can. There's no such thing as perfection, so you'll never peak.
Great way to put it. Anderson can't get it to go. On defense, Houston. 4-point game. Their last game, a win against the Lakers, looking to carry it into this one.
Talked about how in the NBA you've got to earn your points the hard way, and that really wasn't the case in that game for them.
You're right. A lot of wide open spaces. They were running around undefended all night.
And nobody, guys, among the defenders stepping up to challenge him on that drive to the 10.
And Greg, he says thank you very much and sails in for the flush.
But it's surprising, Kev, to see so little urgency on the defensive side, especially with them losing this game right now.
Oh, phenomenal alley-oop slam there.
They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there. Capella kicks to Beverly. Houston moving it around. Shot clock at 6. From deep, Harden. The Rockets again can't hit. The Hornets on offense. Good momentum, 8 straight points. For 3.
Cody Zeller.
And there's Zeller. And that's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got 3 assists tonight. Williams with the block.
After 4 shots, they are still without a main field goal.
Wide open. Again, the Hornets score.
How about the start that they've gotten off to here? Huge lead, and we're still in the first quarter.
I mean, it's really impressive as the Hornets did that while dealing with a bunch of injuries. Everyone was surprised at how strong the Eastern Conference was during the season, and the Hornets were one of those surprise teams leading the way. You could definitely say the Hornets surpassed expectations last season.
Kicks it to Beverly. Out left to the wing. There's the triple. He's off on that one. Walker with some nice D. Here's the Hornets with the ball. It's been 13 unanswered points for him. And there's a whistle that's going to go on James Harden. That's his first foul. Eric Gordon, he's checked in for James Harden. Sessions checked in for the Hornets. The dish to Zeller. And there's the 3-second violation. While we have the chance, we'd like to reveal the list of the past month's best fast break teams in the NBA. In second, the Rockets.
Now, they've been playing an exciting brand of basketball during that time. I mean, taking every chance to get out in the open floor.
Rockets trailed by 13. Here's Gordon. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play.
Shooting one.
It took them a while, but finally they take the lid off.
Well, now that they have the monkey off their backs, hopefully their offense will get better as a result of that.
Catching up in the changes for Houston. Nene, he's checked in for Clint Capella. Decker comes in for Ryan Anderson. Corey Brewer's checked in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Tyler Ennis in for Patrick Beverly. Gordon, the pass to Decker. It's up and it's off the mark. He's 0 for 1. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Marco Bellinelli. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, really good defensive play to cut him off there and square up.
Outside Gordon. And it's Gordon with the finish.
And Kevin, even though they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular, and he did.
Well, maybe this is the best time to do it.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Oh, well, that's because it was terrific anticipation. Also, the quick hands, a lethal combination. Are you kidding me? That's too easy. Where's the defense?
Sessions dishes to Hibbert. Here's Kaminsky. A three-pointer off the mark. Charlotte, their last game, a win against the Detroit Pistons.
Yeah, the bench production in that game was terrific. Points from multiple sources.
Yeah, this is why you keep adding better pieces to the back end of your roster. You never know when you're going to have to call on them.
Now here's Gordon. He has five. From beyond the arc. No good that time. Charlotte leading by six. Out of bounds. Houston takes possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
Decker kicks to Ennis. In the corner, Harrell with it. Here's Nene. And slam dunk by Nene.
And he just elevates and powers in the one-hander.
Mm-hmm. Textbook. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Hornets ahead, up by four. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And when you consider how Charlotte is doing, guys, what do you think?
It's been about the pace. You can see they're going to try to keep this game in the open floor.
And they have the horses to do it. Once they can let loose out in the open, very difficult to match up with.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play. Taking a look at the Rockets. Beverly and Harden are the one and the two. Trevor Ariza up there with Anderson. And it's Harrell in at the five. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, guys, the Charlotte Hornets made a concerted effort last season to improve what had been terrible three-point shooting. Coach Steve Clifford said, if you look at trends in this league, three-point shooting percentage was the number one factor why teams won. That's the way this league is gone. It makes sense, right? Create spacing, which opens up things for everybody else. Kevin?
Yeah, trying to space the floor. Thank you, D.A. Now, here's Walker. He seems to always be finding ways to score, averaging around 23.5 points a game. Here's Kidd Gilchrist. Charlotte needs to get a shot. Batum against Harden. And stolen by Zeller. And now here's Batum, the fast break opportunity. That's tipped. And stolen by Harrell. Ariza kicks to Beverly. Oh, good with the triple.
Solid rebound there. And with the score like it is, that's an area where they can't afford to get lazy.
And for a while, Chris, it seemed that the Rockets were going to be the team to beat in the West for a few years.
Well, yeah, most of us thought Harden and Howard seemed like a great fit on paper, but something just never clicked. The window for their success seemed to be the most wide open when they made it to the conference finals 2 years back. Now, with Howard out of town, they'll have to rebuild and find a new core to build around.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Clint Capella, he's checked in for Houston. Brewer comes in for Trevor Ariza. And a switch here also for Charlotte. Hibbert's checked in. Walker the pass to Hibbert. Back to Walker. From 13. Clock at 4. Zeller. Second shot opportunity. Left side, Kidd Gilchrist. And slam dunk by Kidd Gilchrist.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
Yeah, they're going for the throat.
Two quick fouls. That's bad news for him. He has to keep his hands to himself until halftime.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Decker's checked in for Anderson. And Eric Gordon subbed in for James Harden. Charlotte also making some changes. Kaminsky is checked in for Cody Zeller. Bellinelli comes in for Kidd Gilchrist. And Sessions subbed in that you either played with or against.
Well I'll tell you what, Larry Bird was a big trash talker. And I got a chance to play with him in Dream Team and other basketball-type settings. He was one of them. You also got to go with my man GP, Gary Payton. He was a big trash talker, and I'd probably have to go with my man Larry Bird or GP, Gary Payton, 6'4 GP. I was on a plane with him one time, and he was talking trash in his sleep. So, Gary's somewhere talking right now, playing the game. So, yeah, that's Gary's style. Gary's he's the biggest trash talker I've met.
Here's Bellinelli following the score by Houston. Kaminsky misses. Gets trailed by 9. Gordon dishes to Brewer. So the whistle blows on the shot and 2 free throws for the contact right there.
And Charlotte has had some great players come through in Don too. Not only very talented players, but more memorable players. Guys like Grandmama, Larry Johnson, Muggsy Bowles, just to name a few.
Charlotte making a switch here. Williams has checked in. And thinking about past Hornets stars, Chris, who in your mind was the best ever to put on a Hornets uniform?
Oh, man, you have to think about Larry Johnson, Grandmama. You also have to think about Alonzo Mourning is up there for most fans of the team.
For 3, Gordon. That's miss number 3 for him. Now 2 for 5 from the floor. And then Hibbert with the dunk.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Not sure if they're aware of the 2-for-1 opportunity.
Now, they have to get going here if they want to capitalize on that. Go for the quick bucket here.
Here's Capella. Another shot. Hornets with the rebound. Kaminsky's got his 3rd rebound tonight. The feed to Hibbert. Just 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. Here's Williams in the hoop for his 3rd make from the field. He's 3-for-4 thus far in the contest.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Gordon kicks to Capella. Here's Brewer. No good on the buzzer beater.
And he really just broke out the entire arsenal of post moves there in that first half.
Great activity in the painted area. Lots of energy. Looking to score almost every time he got the ball.
And Charlotte looking at who they've got. Batum teams up with Kidd Gilchrist on the perimeter. Cody Zeller out there with Marvin Williams. And it's Walker in the 1 spot. Capella, the pass to Harden. Walker with some nice D. Well, it sure feels like more and more the league is demanded now. More players with skill at every position. Guys, Chris, who can dribble and pass and shoot. Do you think you'd have been even more valued if you played in today's game?
You know what? Legend once told me not to kind of look back and compare or to wonder about what could have been. And I don't know. I do like the fact that when I had that skill set, it was appreciated by my coach, teammates, and some fans. But for most people back then, they would say you're trying to do too much, or it doesn't mean anything to have five assists a game or to get guys involved. And, you know, for me, I just thought that the more you can do, the better you are at all skill sets, the more you make yourself valuable to your team, the more you should be on the court, and it validates that. So for me, I just took all my favorite players and I stole from them. I wanted to be like them, and I thank the generations that came before me.
Good point. He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, remember when Roy Hibbert burst onto the scene in that great year for the Pacers, and he's still one of the league's elite rim defenders. He doesn't go for the block so much as create a wall. It's called the principle of verticality, and Hibbert says, "I'm the godfather of that." I'm not going to name names, but there were some prominent coaches who said, "You need to get rid of this." But Kevin, here's the rules.
Yeah, D.A., he didn't invent it. He just perfected it. Thanks. During your career in Sacramento, Chris, you played on one of the most up-tempo teams of the era. Just how much fun is it for a player to play in a system like that?
Well, first of all, you better be in shape and have your track shoes on at all times. And secondly, it is fun because the faster the game is played, the more mistakes that are made. And so hopefully, if you're executing, more mistakes will be made on the defense's part of the game. And when that happens, you get a lot of highlight plays. You get involved. You get the crowd engaged. The energy, this part of it is so different. So those are some fun days playing out there with my boys, and you know, had some of the best times out there with that exciting fast tempo type play.
I like that.
The shooting percentage continues to elevate here in the second half.
They have come out of the locker room with a real fire and desire to get more high quality looks at the basket,
and they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
Harden against Batum. Harden kicks to Beverly. Down low. Batum with the steal. And here's the fast break. Walker leading the way. Batum, good.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Here's Beverly. From deep, Harden. Another miss by Harden.
And he's been way off the mark this quarter. It's been ugly. And as they continue to just dominate this game, you have to wonder how much can they win by.
Well, some people call it front running, but as the league continues to expand, their confidence continues to soar right now.
And here's Anderson from the arc. Hits it from three-point range. Anderson's got 5 points now this quarter. Out of bounds, Houston takes possession. And for the uninitiated, Mike D'Antoni has a bit of a unique offensive approach. Likes, in fact, Chris, to create a lot of chances for his team by pressing the tempo.
Well, he creates a lot of chances and doesn't mind the early shot. He'll go with the undersized four to help push the tempo. It's all about getting easy transition buckets for D'Antoni.
Catching up on the changes for Houston. Harrell, he's checked in for Anderson. Gordon comes in for James Harden. And it's Tyler Ennis in for Patrick Beverly. Sam Decker's checked in for Houston. Brewer comes in for Trevor Ariza. Williams, he's checked in for Charlotte. Sessions, no good. Rockets trail by 19. Throws it up high. Williams with the steal. Shoots from the elbow. That doesn't go in either for Sessions. Houston's gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Williams with the block. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Williams. Clint Capella, he's checked in for Houston. And out of bounds as the Hornets gain possession.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Charlotte, leading by 19 points. And that's out of bounds. Charlotte will retain possession.
Well, close to picking that one off.
Oh, he gets a great jump on it, barely bounces off his fingertips.
Sessions with it. Looking for his first basket still in this one. And it's out of bounds. The Hornets able to retain possession here. Here's Sessions. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game.
Cold start to this game for him. A lot of his shots have been off.
Decker gets the bucket. There's 10 seconds left here in the third quarter. Feeds it to Kaminsky. Charlotte no good that time either. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. And the Rockets with possession here, trailing by 17. They've got Clint Capella. Gordon is out there with Patrick Beverley. Then there's Harrell, and it's Ariza in at the three. That's the five for Houston right now. Now here's Batum. Here's Williams. Slammed home, and he draws the foul. A chance for another point at the free throw line.
Shooting one.
It's going to be on Montrezl Harrell.
Beautiful lead pass. The finisher never has to break stride.
And the Rockets making a change here. Anderson's checked in. And a switch here also for Charlotte. Kemba Walker is checked in for Sessions.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
And just dropping the ball down inside, a timely assist.
Gordon with it. Williams picks him up. A nice shot by Anderson.
He's not the most prolific shooter from downtown, but someone on defense still has to check him.
Hornets leading by 21. And there's the call on Patrick Beverley. And that'll be his third foul so far. The NBA game more analyzed than ever before. The teams are competing against one another, but also, Chris, we're seeing the league is sharing a lot more information with fans. Analytics now becoming a very important part of it.
Well, I think the one thing that you have to remember about analytics, though, is that there isn't a consistent variable. It doesn't take into account what a guy went through that day, the defender that's playing against him, whether it's cold, whether it's warm. So I caution a little bit about...